Good morning, folks. All right, well, let's see. Last time we were on here, we caught that one that kind of died on us, or did die on us. It was, we weighed out, it was 772. Then we had the, ran right into the tournaments. We were fishing the lure makers, and yeah, we, you know, we caught a couple fish, we had some bites, you know, had some shots. It just wasn't our tournament, but we had a good time. You know, one day we were right up there. You know, the fishing was slow. The first day there were a bunch of qualifiers. They were like, that was a bit, like kind of bit first day, a couple qualifiers, a couple rats. And then we had the biggest south swell probably in like 20 years hit. And it kind of, I mean, I always say it, I feel like it messes up the fishing somehow. But there was that, and there was also a hurricane that hit us, but just the fishing was just really tough. Real hit and miss after that point. Chris Choi ended up winning on the last day with like a 600 some counter. It was good to see. He's a great fisherman. He's fishing on one of those like a 37 Merit, but the Rybovich is, you know, old classic boat. He takes really good care of. Awesome fisherman, awesome fishing family. His brother Sam's a good fisherman. So we were stoked to see him win. That was, you know, if we're not gonna win, it's nice to see one of the good guys pull in some money. So I was really happy to see that. Congratulations, Chris, on the Sambo. But anyways, we're back out here. Day off, and I flew over to Maui and caught the tail end of this swell, the biggest swell in like I said, 20 years. And there's a wave over there in front of the harbor. Hasn't broken since like 2005, and it was freaking insane. Like the best, longest barrels, probably some of the longest barrels I've had in my life for sure, but definitely the longest barrels I've ever had here in Hawaii. Best waves I've probably had here in Hawaii. So that was pretty epic. Flew over there, strike mission, surf, boom. Back here now, into charters. Got charters every day until the rest of the end of the month. And like I said, we're just gonna keep the good vibes rolling and try and catch us a big one here. Should be one around. Current's still ripping north, so I'll be working really hard edges. Stand by, we'll find a big one here.
There you go. Pick up, reel down. Reel it, stop, now come back. Now go down. We got you. Don't worry.
Oh shit!
Out. But. It's all right. Now just relax. Relax your arm. All right, we're gonna get a shot on leader here. Good job. Good job. Keep pumping. She's making it look easy. A bit more. There's the double. Keep going. A little bit more.
Nobody's going swimming.
Woo! Oh, there he goes. Oh, it was around his bill and all wrapped up on it, but we still got. See him gone? Go chase him, Cap. Great job. Woo! Yeah, dude.
That was excellent.
All right, folks, so we caught one right there. Probably close to three. I was just scared. We just changed up the bullet, the stinger. I put out a Aloha Lure's Magic Malolo and had it out there and I was looking at it and it kind of running funny, and then I got this other tack and it started running really good and I was watching and I was like, oh yeah, now it's running really good. And I'm looking at it, I'm like, oh yeah, that's what I wanted. Just when I seen him come up on it. There he is, stinger. Came up and ate it. Got him. He was all wrapped up in the leader. JJ grabbed the leader and kind of pulled on it. Kind of rolled out of the leader there. And when he did, we pulled the hook off. But they should call that a Palm Beach release or whatever. But it's a release fish. And it just kind of sat there and swam away, all lit up. Pretty cool. So. Good stuff. But anyways, that's one. We can catch another one here. It's been a little bit slow today, but been working a pretty hard edge right here. And then I was up off this area of Red Hill. There was some bait, looked good. I saw Teddy catch one in there. Saw someone catch a tuna. A little bit more life. The current's starting to slow down just a little bit. It's still smoking, but it's a little bit slowed down. So that's a good sign. Yeah, so one blue down. Beautiful day out here. was just saying how we're about to get bit. We definitely called that one. All right, on again. You can push that drag up a little bit, just up to like the next.
Got the yellow.
All right, there you go.
Trying to kick around here a little longer. I'm like, oh my god, there's a couple in here, man. Like, these guys are, might be a little bit late, but wherever.
Hey, we have nowhere else.
All right. I was about to be like, hey, do you mind if we're like 30 minutes late? Like, it's gonna bite in here.
Gosh, this area started looking really good down here. I just didn't want to leave. I was like, hey, look, guys. You know, they fished. They put their time in really cool people. You know, both of them have never caught a blue marlin. They've fishing their whole lives and stuff, so we just got one for his wife, and I said, I think there's one in here, let's just kick it. And just then I went way in shallow, I saw the bait doing what it's supposed to be doing up inside here, which is like generally what July like usually would look like, but now it's starting to look like summer out here, you know. So anyways, I was just telling the JJ up in the bridge, like, look at this, this is what it's supposed to look like. Like, and just then, bam, piled on the right long. Just a little one, but still blue marlin. We got to it super quick. Like, I think we had one rod is still in the water, and I was getting just about to the leader. I was like, get your gloves on, come on, let's get this thing. Get back out here and try and, you know, there's gotta be a big one here, so. Anyways, caught that one. So they both caught their first blue marlin, so husband and wife. Checking the blue marlin off the box. Good vibes. Kona, Hawaii. Yes, sir. All right. We're going to start trolling home now. Maybe we'll be interrupted with another one. Of the larger model. All right. Stand by.
Congratulations.
All right, folks, well, that's that for today. bullets. One was on a Aloha Lure's feather sword, the large bullet. The other was on a, One was on a Aloha Lure's magic Malolo. The other was on a Lure's feather sword, large bullet. The flag's flying. Happy people. Tomorrow's another day. We'll be out here again. Goodbye.
Alright, so this is a little tradition. When you catch your first blue, you gotta jump in the water. There you go. You got your first blue marlin. See you guys tomorrow.
What's up, guys? So today's GC Tackle Company tip of the day is talking about a lure called the Smash Bait, made by Aloha Lures. I like to run mine on the long corner. Typically that bait likes to pull a little bit to that side, so I find if I run it on the short corner, I can get it to run good by kind of manipulating the coil on the hook, but running on the long corner, the angle, the distance back, the position, everything runs, it just runs so good on the long corner. I'm gonna hop over real quick to an interview I did with Eric, who actually is the creator of that lure. Tell you a little bit about the history of it, interview I did for GC Lures. So let's hop over to that.
Brief story on the Smash Bait, because that has become really popular. And you know, when I was growing up making lures, I had a little wood lathe, and everything was cut on the wood lathe, every piece. And the Smash Bait was actually a big blank that I made to cut down to size. So I made the biggest thing I could make. I made it in like a long orange juice canister and made this master, made the angle. And that was, you know, before I had explored all my, you know, the angle options, so to speak. It was just a blank. It was just meant to be a blank. And at the time I was fishing with Ray Quarter on the Pacific Blue in Honolulu. I was 17, and he asked me to make him one of the big ones, because that's what he wanted, was the biggest thing possible, because he loved his marlin fishing. And so I poured him one of these big blanks, but it was bigger than I was normally used to pouring. And when you pour more volume of resin, that's really challenging to especially depending on the kinds of inserts you have in there, not to have cracks and overheating. And this one cracked. And it didn't split and shatter, but it cracked.
Yeah.
And I gave it to him, and it was a little squished, and it wasn't perfectly round. But he spent about 3 weeks walking around the harbor after our charters, hand sanding this thing, polishing this down, and that lure was phenomenal. And that was really the origins of the modern Smash Bait.
Alright, guys, well, we're back here. Today is not my favorite day to fish because there's a skiff tournament, so a tournament for smaller boats. It's called the Wee Guys. They do it once a year. It's like a 2-day tournament, and everybody with a skiff, anything from like a 10-foot whaler to, I don't know what their maximum size limit is, maybe like 25, 30 feet. But all like outboard trailer boats, skiffs, and because it is Kona, the guys in the skiffs can catch some big fish. Over the years, there's been some monsters caught in this tournament on little boats. So, but the only thing with this is there's a lot of boats in it, and some of the guys might only fish these 2 days a year. So you just got to be a little bit careful. There's probably over 100 boats in it. And on top of that, there's another tournament. But yeah, so there's a lot of boats out here today. So we'll see if we can sneak a couple out from under everybody here and just catch a couple quietly and have a good day on the water. Yeah, there is a lot of boats around me right now. I have to be pretty much on point today because a lot of these guys pull their stinger on a bird and they pull that thing so far back. I swear, it is like freaking in a different area code. It's insane, but you gotta really be careful. Thank God they put a bird on it so you can see it, or you'd be running over their stingers all day. It kind of reminds me of that scene from Jaws where they're kind of like, they put out a bounty to kill the shark and like all the skiffs go out and they're like throwing dynamite and they're like running into each other and it's just chaos. I don't know, it kind of reminds me of that one. There's some real good dudes on the skiffs fishing, some real tigers. And, you know, it's cool. It's always cool to see guys, you know, in like a 20-foot skiff, you know, catch an 800 pounder or whatever, you know. So, anyways, good luck to them today, and good luck to me that I do not run over anyone's stinger. And anyways, let's go fishing. See if we can find them. New transmission. Quiet riot going on back there.
Gain. Oh yeah! There you go, pick up, reel down. Now stand up, sit up, all the way up, reel on the way down. Stop, pull it back, reel on the way down. Stand up, stop, come back. Go. Come back. There you go, keep going. Stay with it, we got a long way to go, but that's all right. There you go again. Yep, good job. Just like that. Nice and easy. Yee-hoo! Angry Joker. That's all right. That's all right. Keep going if you can. Yep, go. Stop, come back. Go all the way down again. Oh, geez. All right, go ahead. Oh yeah, got some drag on him now. Yeah, I saw the hole even when I ran all the way out. Hell yeah. That was gonna eat. 200 pounder, I think, yeah? We'll see when he gets up. Got Bobby at the beach chilling with us. There you go, just like that. Just try to do the motion, pick up, reel down. Go if you can go. You might be able to gain a lot here quick. You might come up for a jump, guys. Watch it. Maybe not, gain if you can. Gain. There you go. cruising on the surface. Here we go. The double. A little bit more. A little bit more, one more pump.
When I came over to your house, I dreamt that I was bleeding out.
Phew, there he is.
With you inside my mouth.
Come on along, sir. Beautiful. See that little hole right there? That's from a shark. It's from a cookie cutter shark. That's a little remora right there. We ready? All right, here we go. See you later. Woo! That was awesome. Give me some.
Right, well, we just got one there. Was very, very, very slow day so far. The tournament, I think I've heard of about 3 blue marlin that were caught out of the tournament, so very slow day out here. We were lucky to find that little bugger. I don't know what up north. I mean, it's been kind of a mess with a lot of people around, so you kind of been hard to really fish the spots I want. So came down an area I wanted to fish, and it was just kind of funky with a lot of boats in the way and whatever, so I went up north, fished around there for a while, and I thought I'll come back up here closer to that tide change, like right on the tide change, and I'll fish here through the tide change. At that point, I figured most of the skiffs will be up by the harbor and the area will be clear. So sure enough, came down, I seen Marlin Parker hook a tuna just out wide. Started feeling kind of good here, went down the line to inside to the little ledge in there, came out, started working back up. Boom, fish came up on that on the right long, the tantrum large bullet, the feather sword. Came up on it, just completely missed it, just out of the water bite. Ah, like, oh crap. We're messing around with some teasers, so JJ was down there crimping some stuff. I go, oh, there he is, blah, blah, blah. Stand there trying to tease him, and the next thing I know, I seen him just come up on the stinger dorsal out of the water, just freaking came up, ate the stinger. Got her on. Just small fish, but nice to get bit, especially when it's slow like this. So especially with that brand new transmission. We also missed another one this morning, so we're 1 for 2. I like that. I like that we're seeing fish. So yeah. It's we're not lighting the world on fire, but we caught a blue marlin, so that's always good. Hopefully the fish will increase and we'll just keep finding them. But alright. Got about another hour, so I'm gonna start kind of heading back, but on it again tomorrow. Drag up a little bit.
And yeah, we're on. First thing in the morning. There you go, good job, good job. Is it a stripey? No, it's a chucker. Short bill spearfish coming in. Oh. Sweet! Beautiful little chucker. Nice fish.
Yeah, nice little one.
Alright, see if we can release him. Alright, I guess he's not ready. There he goes.
Way to go.
Sweet! Guys. Good job.
There it is.
Alright, well there we go. We got one out of the way first thing here this morning. We got a nice little spearfish, a little chucker. They have been very few of them around lately, so yeah, let her go. Got some pictures and sent her on her way, and yeah, back at it early in the morning. I don't think it's even 8 o'clock yet, so next one should be a big blue. I hope. A little bit of wind today, we'll see what that does. Yeah, the fishing is got a little bit flaky again here with the moon, but we're past the full now. The full was yesterday, so hopefully we'll start seeing a little more action. But the big girls don't care about that, so we'll see if we find a big one here today. Stand by.
Good job. Coming up, you should probably see a jump here soon. Just stand back if we grab the leader, okay? Keep going, man, keep going. Gain line, put your elbow up high. Whip the eggs. There we go. There's the hanger. Yep, go. Gain. Guide the line. Go. This is what we're gonna gain. Boy, a bullet. Reel. Stay with him. Gotta keep up with the boat. Keep tension on him. Go. All right. He's right there. We're pretty close. We can just gain a little bit more. We can get him quick. Oh! Reel if you can. We're gonna get him. He's right there. Reel if you can. Please. Go. Getting him. Alright, it's right there. Just reel until right there. Almost there, man. see. It's right there. Reel, 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 reel. Reel, 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 reel. Go, go, go. Stay on him. Go, go, go. All right, all right. Really close. Come on, this fish has been a pain. Go, go, go if you can, man. Fish. Reel, 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 reel. Yes, sir. Go, 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 go. Here's the leader. Board. Yes, sir. Good job, Cap.
All right, we just released one here. We are 1 for 2 on the blue, and we also caught a spearfish. So we got a little bit of action going on here, which is good. Which is good. We are. On the hunt. On the hunt. We continue to look for a big one. The current kind of switched on us today, so we moved around a little bit. We made the right call. So that's good, that's good. But on to the next one.